Good day, students. You are welcome to our BST Chemistry class today. This class is for SS2 students. And our topic today is a continuation of what we started during our last video, endothermic and exothermic processes. So today our lesson is based on the following objectives: that at the end of this lesson, students should be able to define exothermic reaction and endothermic reaction, give examples of endothermic processes, and also state differences between an exothermic and an endothermic reaction. So these are our objectives, and I hope you pay attention. Take down necessary things, bring your pen and your paper close to you, and if you have any question, do well to direct it to me in our Google classroom. Okay, what is an endothermic reaction? So the word endothermic is a word that is gotten from two words: endo, which means inside, and thermic, which means heat. So in the last video, I told you people that thermic is also gotten from thermal. And when we are talking about thermal, we are talking about heat, temperature, thermometer, thermocool. So all these things are talking about heat. So an endothermic reaction is something that happens inside. So the word endothermic means, or an endothermic reaction is a type of reaction in which energy is gained from the surrounding in the form of heat energy. So when a reaction process gains energy from the surrounding, it is called an endothermic reaction. When, remember our exothermic reaction, we said that when a reaction process releases energy to the surrounding, when a reaction process releases energy to the surrounding in the form of heat. Now I told you that example of that reaction is when you burn something, or when you burn paper. You see that that reaction process, or that combustion process that goes down, results in the release of heat to the surroundings. So if you come around that reaction system, you see that you'll be feeling the heat. I gave you an assignment which most of you have done and returned the answer or recorded their observation. I told you to put a little detergent in your hand and add a few drops of water, and tell me the temperature you feel. You see that you feel the heat of that reaction process because it is an exothermic process. What happens in an exothermic process is that heat is lost to the environment. So this process, or this reaction system, releases heat to the environment so that you can even feel the heat on our bodies. Okay, but an endothermic process is the opposite of an exothermic process, in that instead of releasing heat to the surrounding, it takes heat from the surrounding. Hello? I said an endothermic process takes heat from the surrounding. What does it do? It does this by cooling our environment. So when you have an endothermic system, it makes the environment to become cold instead of being hot. I repeat again, an endothermic process makes the environment to become cold instead of being hot. Okay, examples. Let's look at these examples. Melting of ice. Now when you bring an ice block or an ice cube from your freezer and keep it. You see that within some few minutes, the ice will begin to melt. How does this ice melt? It melts by taking the heat that is in our environment. So it is now absorbing heat from our environment into its own body, thereby making our environment what? Cool. Hello? I repeat, when an ice is melting, what it does is that it takes away the heat that is in our environment, thereby making our environment to become cold, and then absorbing this heat into the reaction system, so thereby becoming water. I hope this is making sense. Or melting of solids. When you are melting solids, let's assume you take your rubber or your plastic and put it on fire. What it does in that moment is that it absorbs heat from the fire or from the surroundings to become liquid, and itself becomes hot, so that the heat from the surroundings will leave the surroundings, so that the surroundings will become cold. Okay, just imagine a reaction process or in a system whereby you are cooking. Okay, take this as an assignment. I repeat again, take this as an assignment. Get an ice block. Get an ice block. Put it in a cup. Get an ice block. Put it in a cup. Now boil a little water, maybe half cup of water, and pour it inside the cup containing the ice cube or ice block. When you pour it, allow it for some minutes. After a few minutes, you see that the water will become cold. I mean the hot water will become cold, while the ice will also melt. I want you to do this at home. Report your observation in the Google Classroom. But what you will notice is that this ice will melt, leaving you a cold water. How or what has happened in this process is that the ice or that reaction system has absorbed the heat from the surrounding. The surrounding is the hot water. Remember, you put it inside hot water. So it has absorbed the heat from the hot water, itself becomes liquid, while the hot water becomes cold. Therefore, endothermic processes introduces cold to the environment, while an endothermic process or exothermic process introduces heat to the environment. Another process is conversion of liquid to gases, and etc. Okay, let's look at this system. This is an energy profile diagram. Remember, in our other video, in our earlier video, I gave you an energy profile diagram for an exothermic reaction, where you had the reactant on top and the product below, looking at the energy absorbed. Now you see that the energy absorbed of the product is higher than that of the reactant. Remember, the reactant was on top in the previous video of the energy profile diagram. Now the product is on top. This shows that the product has gained energy from the surrounding, thereby it has a higher energy than the reactant. And I told you that this heat content of the body is also known as enthalpy. Enthalpy. And the enthalpy change, we call it delta H in chemistry. Delta H is calculated by heat of the product minus heat of the reactant. Now, the heat of the product is higher than the heat of the reactant. Therefore, the entropy of the reaction system at the end of the reaction will be positive. Let's assume that the heat content at the beginning of the reaction is 100 kilojoules per mole, and at the end of the reaction, the heat, because it has absorbed heat from the environment, the heat now increased from 100 to 300 kilojoules per mole. Now, if you want to calculate the heat of the reaction, or the enthalpy change, I told you that it's heat of product minus heat of reactant. Therefore, the enthalpy change is equal to 300 minus 200, which will give us plus 200 kilojoule per mole. Now, in the case of a reactant or in a reaction system whereby it is exothermic, heat will be lost in the environment. I think I gave you 60-40 or 60-100, where you have minus 40 as the enthalpy or the enthalpy of the body. So in an endothermic process, the enthalpy change is usually positive, while in an exothermic process, the enthalpy change is usually negative. Okay, look at this diagram. I showed you this diagram in our previous video. This is the diagram by the left, an endothermic process. You can see the arrow pointing towards the ice cube, whereby it is getting heat from the surroundings. And you can see also a flame of a burning substance going out, and the arrows pointing outwards, showing that heat is lost to the surrounding. So this is a typical example of an endothermic process and an exothermic process. Now let's look at these differences between exothermic process and endothermic process. So pay attention to this table. This is where we'll be ending our class today. So I told you that an endothermic process is a process in which heat is absorbed from the surrounding, while an exothermic process is a process in which heat is given out to the surrounding. That is our number one difference. Number two, I said that the sum of enthalpies of products is greater than the sum of enthalpies of reactants. The sum of enthalpies of products is greater than the sum of enthalpy of reactants. Also note that in the exothermic process or in an exothermic reaction, the sum of enthalpies of the product is less than the sum of enthalpies of the reactant. What did I say is enthalpy? Enthalpy is the heat content of the body, and it is presented by the letter H. So if we want to calculate this, we say it is what, delta H, that means change in enthalpy. Okay, number three, we said that the heat of reaction is what, positive, while in exothermic process, the heat of reaction is negative. Now, in endothermic process, you said that products are less stable than reactants, while in endothermic process, products are more stable than reactants. Okay, to justify this, let's look at this picture again. You can see that as the product is being formed, you see that the ice cube is melting. So instability is now in question. It's no longer stable, it's changing from solid to liquid. While in an exothermic process, the products are more stable than the reactant because it has absorbed heat from the surrounding. Okay, remember the experiment I told you to conduct at home? When you go home, put an ice cube in a cup, pour a little hot water, allow it to stay for some minutes, come back and check the temperature of the hot water. You see that the temperature has reduced, because the ice cube has given or absorbed the heat from the surrounding, thereby cooling the surrounding. Please do this, observe it, and report. If there is, if your own did not happen this way, or you have a contrary idea of this, please do report in our Google classroom. You can discuss about it. If you have any question, please do well also to ask in our Google classroom. Okay, this is where we stop today. Thank you for being part of this class. Stay safe and stay home.